right, so I want to clear up a little bit of confusion about an interchange of words, and that is, what is a consultation? And a little bit more specifically, what is a consultation in comparison to examination? There are people that actually believe that the consultation and examination are the same thing, and that leads to a lot of confusion. I say this from experience because it's not unusual for someone to make a phone call and schedule a time for a consultation with us, only to find out that it was not an examination as they expected. So I'm hoping that this little short video will explain a few things so that there will be a lot less confusion. Now, if you've never met me before, our initial conversation would be very similar to the type of a conversation that we would have at a cocktail party. So quite often, these initial consults we call in our office a cocktail party consultation. That's just where I would explain what's a dental implant, what's a porcelain veneer, things in general. However, most people, when they're scheduling a time with me for a consultation, they want to know two main things. Am I a candidate for the treatment, and how much it's going to cost? Now, that's where things become a challenge, because I can't quote a fee without actual doing proper diagnostic records and an examination. I need to know everything about you and that tooth or teeth or the situation. It's not unusual for people to say, I just want you to take a real quick peek and tell me what you see, what would it take to fix? And that's where the confusion becomes, because that's impossible. I actually need all of that diagnostic information. Now, the photographs and the x-rays have two benefits. Number one, I know everything about you and the situation, but it also allows me to communicate to you what it is that I see, and so that you can actually understand what it is that we propose, and you would know what all of your options would be. From these records, I can plan and design your case so that we can have no surprises. Now, those that say that they don't want x-rays, they don't want to have the diagnostic records, what you're saying is those are absolutely useless and unnecessary, which couldn't be any further from the truth. Now, we do have some people that will arrive bringing their own records, and if they're current, many times we can use those. The uncomfortable thing is, though, if the records are old or not of diagnostic quality. And I will say that there are many dental offices that their x-rays might be out of focus. The photographs might not show everything that I need to know. Or they're 3 years old, and a lot can happen within 3 years. So we need current x-rays. We need current photographs for us to discuss a current situation. Now, sometimes people will come to my office and say that a previous office did a free consultation, and they actually may have actually done a free examination. I don't know why they don't feel that they're worth any fee. I don't know why they think they're worthless, because if they were worth something, they would have charged a fee. But I am an expert in the field, and as such, having spent the years in training, my expert opinion comes with its own fee. Very similar to if you were to go to an attorney's office. I think it's reasonable to expect the attorney would charge you a fee for being there. I don't believe you will get any time with an attorney at no charge. This does come down to you truly do get what you pay for. And if you've gotten a free exam, perhaps you should ask yourself what it was worth.